Welcome back to Proactive London, where I'm talking now to Martin Gouldstone. He is the CEO of Oncimmune. And before we delve into today's interview, Martin, firstly, a very warm welcome, and it's great to meet you. How are you?
I'm great, Tom. Thanks very much. And thanks very much for inviting me onto the podcast. Very nice to meet you.
It's a real pleasure. We haven't heard from anybody from Oncimmune since March. And I know that there has been a lot going on, hasn't there, including your arrival and a complete change of strategy. So I'm going to ask Martin to start with, what is the new strategy?
So I joined on the 1st of August, and the first point of action really was to review the strategy of the business. The business is essentially being relaunched. So with the disposal of the early lung CDT business to Freenome back in May, really the business is centered around our labs in Dortmund and the immune insights platform. So my job is really to maximize the commercial and the scientific value in that platform. And so what the strategy that we announced back on October the 12th is really centered around that. So it's expanding the reach, the types of work that the platform can do across drug discovery and development, but also expanding our reach into different customer verticals. So expanding from big pharma to smaller biopharma who are more nimble and entrepreneurial, and through to partnering with CROs, both translational medicine and clinical CROs, to expand our commercial reach.
They've kind of come to the right place in asking you to do this, haven't they? Because you do have experience in a lot of these exact fields.
I do, yes. My background goes back to 1990 when I first joined the industry with Pharmacia. But I've been in major CROs, two major CROs in corporate finance and fundraising roles. And I've been a corporate financier as well for 5 years, advising companies on buy side, sell side, that kind of stuff. So yes, I've got a fair background.
So you've had around, 4 or 5 months in the hot seat there, something like that. Firstly, what have you achieved? And secondly, how happy are you with what you've achieved, Martin?
Yeah, so I think we've achieved a lot. So we've really done a root and branch review of the business, from finances through operations through to the strategy as we presented. I'm really pleased, actually, with the way that it feels like the business is coming together. We have a very productive and happy team in Dortmund in Germany with world-leading scientists. When I came here, I was very pleased to see that we had relationships with several large pharma and MSAs in place with some of them, which is hard to achieve for a small business, and the business needs to be congratulated on that. We've built out the commercial team. We'll be 5 in the commercial team early next year. And we've also announced just this week 4 deals that have been signed, which actually are against the new strategy and showing early commercial traction from that strategic process. So I've been very encouraged by all of that, and I've really enjoyed the role. I've really enjoyed the job in the past 4 months.
Hopefully that positivity will be rubbing off on the rest of the organization, because obviously it has been a bruising time for the whole sector. Now, turning to the subject of the new year, can people expect more of the same from you based on your track record so far?
Well, it's obviously hard, Tom, to be totally predictive and specific, but we also, as I think we put in the press release, have a number of other agreements in discussion at the moment. And I'm greatly encouraged by the growth and health of our pipeline. So I would hope so very much, yes.
Well, unless there's anything that you'd like to add today, Martin, I'm just going to wish you the very best of luck for 2024.
Many thanks, Tom. I appreciate that.